Welcome back, or welcome for the first time, to TM1 Bikes Weekend Edition. It is the practice and qualifying session for Yokohama Race 6 of the 2020 Asia Pacific Super Cup. Did you notice the little train going past down there? I thought that was really cool. Just thought I'd mention that, but we have business to attend to, and the first order of business is the configuration screen, so I'll just splash that up. We now have great front wings and gearboxes for both cars. The great one on Farah slash Tang's car is, in fact, the last development part. So it has plus 40 in the race, but minus 10 in reliability there. Nonetheless, it's an improvement over what we've had before. If we take a look at the comparison to the base cars, Porter's car is 8.87% better, and Snidely's is 6.1% better. Nonetheless, it's still not probably going to do us very much good in qualifying. We are, of course, going to be sending out Little Max and also Leonzio for the practice session, and I shall do the car setup and come back to you. Little Max. Right, the key parts on this particular track are, what are they, brakes and front wing and suspension, if I remember correctly. In any case, all acceleration all the time. You just take a look at the layout of the track, you can see that is accelerating as hell. So that means high downforce, and I'm going to push this up to 18.1, 28.1, going a little bit lower on Leonzio just to see whether there is a better result there. Tire pressure, we could probably go a little bit lower on that, but I'm going to keep it in the neutral zone just because I don't know that there's that much to be gained from it. Minus 2.8 is an acceleration camber, of course, not ultra acceleration. I could probably go to 3.2 there, but let's start at 2.8, which is pretty much my default setting for acceleration tracks. In terms of suspension stiffness and gear ratios, I have had limited experience on this track, obviously. I've done a couple of single races on there. What I've noticed is that it tends to go a little bit to the hard side, and also for the gear ratios, a little bit to the long side. Now, I have no idea why that is, because obviously this track is acceleration as hell. You've only got a straight down here and also past the pit lane. But nonetheless, I've found that a little bit over the middle is where they have tended to like to be. Now, I had originally set the suspension a little bit over there, just a little bit towards the soft side, but as you can see, that actually takes Porter outside the mechanics recommended zone. So I've got it sitting right on the edge there. We'll see what his reaction to that is, and from there we should know. We're probably going to have to go to the understeer side. We should know one way or the other. Tire choice is going to be mediums. We're going to try to get another six pack, so that's basically three lots on each of the characteristics, so that we can have whichever advantages we choose, whichever performance bonuses we choose, it's going to be two lots of three. And to do that, we're going to have to go out on both mediums and on softs at some point. I want to keep both of the cars out on the one tire type at the one time so that I get a better idea of when we need to pull them in and switch over to the other one, so we're not wasting time building up experience points that we don't need. It's easier to do that if both cars are out on the same tyre, so I've decided to do mediums first. There's no particular reason for that. We could do softs first, but mediums will be fine there. In the case of Leonzio, similar situation. I've gone a little bit less on the front wing angle than the rear wing angle, simply to see if there is a difference in response there. This is actually sitting him right on the border there also, so at least once we get the feedback there, it's probably going to have to go towards the low side for him, so we'll know exactly, well, we won't know exactly because that's kind of hard with the downforce. We will have a general idea of how far we need to move to clear up the downforce and get it to where we need it to be. Tire pressure, same thing, straight down the middle. Tire camber, a little bit towards the acceleration side. Handling, again, just a little bit beyond the midpoint of both suspension stiffness and also gear ratios. We'll just see how he feels about that. Tire choice, I've changed him over to mediums. I think he was originally on soft. One of them was on soft and I've changed them over, but in any case, that'll be fine. Just go over here and we are good to go. Continue. Take the practice and go in paused. Right, who's out? Oh, oi! That didn't pause. I hit the space bar, but it didn't register. Okay, so obviously the thing we need to work out is the stints. So they've got Little Max on qualifying trim. I hate it when they do that. Going to give him fuel for 3 laps because it seems, I don't know whether this is right or not, but I've noticed that since we've started adopting the principle of sending them out for at least one flying lap, rather than sending them out and bringing them straight back in, the rate at which the active knowledge builds up seems to be going faster. Now, it's hard to discern when it's actually in the process of building up, but I've noticed that we seem to be able to get higher results if we don't just cause their outlap to become their in-lap as well. I need to test that out and see whether it's my imagination or whether it's really happening. That seems to be the case, and therefore, I'm going to let Little Max at least do one flying lap before we bring him back in. Okay, in the case of Leonzio, right, this time it paused. Okay, send out. Right, what's Leonzio on? Leonzio is on race trim, 4 laps. Yeah, because I'm going to bring him in before 4 laps anyway, so I want to see what his setup is. I think it's probably okay-ish, but I doubt that it's going to be perfect. So we'll give him just a couple of laps. All right, send him out. Let's go. Get up to 2 times. I'm not going to bring either of them up to a higher mode with either tyres or engine, because the thing is that the active knowledge is based on the time on track, so it doesn't necessarily matter. Like I said, if we're not making the outlap be also the in-lap, then it doesn't actually matter whether they are going out in high mode or not. We don't need them to get around fast because they're still racking up this precious active knowledge. But you see the medium tyres is coming up to level 1 rather nicely, which is fine. Aero's feeling great right now, just the right setup. If I could ever believe any of those radio messages, I'd be pleased about that. For us, we're purple on Sector 1, but that doesn't mean anything because obviously, as the rubber builds up, everybody is going to start moving faster. Let's slow down a little bit so they have both. No, they haven't. I don't think they've done a flying lap yet. No, they must be on their first flying lap now. They're in Sector 2. Should be coming up to Sector 3. There they go, first and second. Right, now, Little Max I will bring in first probably because he has the lesser amount of fuel, so I might as well bring him in on this one. Whereabouts is he? Okay, we'll bring him in there. Johnny Navarro, that's irrelevant. Okay, come on, Little Max. Hurry, hurry. Get you up to 2 times to bring him in a little bit faster. Yeah, they're dropping down the field. That's not worrying me because, I mean, they're out there on mediums. Well, I'll admit that I've seen far worse. Now, I was originally going to experiment with upping the wing angle, but to be perfectly honest, this is a game, this funny old game of motor racing that does not seem to like extremes. So I'm going to actually lower that instead, back to 17.9, 27.9. In terms of the handling, obviously it's going to need to be one notch. If that's great, hopefully that will be excellent at 60. Whoa, not the other way. 81. Hopefully that will be excellent at 81. 63, the speed balance has shifted slightly, but I'm just going to leave that for the moment. We know where it is, so we can come back to it if we need to. If that takes it out of the excellent zone, we can tweak around the tyre pressure and tyre camber to try to get back to it. But hopefully this will be okay. Stints, I'm going to up him to 3. I hate the fact that that goes out with only 1 on it because it just doesn't give you enough time when you're in qualifying trim. All right, so medium tyres is about halfway along the line to level 2. Little Max can't be out for more than about 3 or 4 laps on this occasion. Combined with Leonzio, that should be enough to push them up to about level 3 by the time Little Max comes back in. Actually, Leonzio, maybe I should have given him an extra lap. I should have given him the 8 laps just to be on the safe side, but no, it's okay. We shall see how that is going at the time that we need to bring Leonzio in. In the meantime, Little Max, 15 seconds for your changeover time. Your time starts now. Go! Leonzio, what's your fuel like? 3.02. Handling is spot on, so you say. Let's see what you say when you come back into the pits. All right. Active knowledge is about 3/4 of the way to level 2. Let's get up to 2 times. Actually, let's get up to 4 times. The temperature, I should have actually checked that, 28 degrees. and no sign of rain. That was actually what the forecast was, but I still should have checked it anyway because the forecast has a tendency to be wrong. Okay, we should be hitting level 2 on medium tyres right about now. Now, let's go back to one type. Leonzio has only got 1.8. He's in 13th. I can bring him in this time. I will bring him in this time, because otherwise he's going to start running very low on fuel. Little Max has 3.81. Where are we with respect to the medium tyres? Little Max, if I leave him out for the full distance, may be able to make it. Be kind to Green Faces Week. I would rather not send Leoncio out on mediums again if I can avoid it. If I can get that extra bit out of Little Max's stint, then Leoncio can flip over to softs immediately. Either that, or I'm going to bring him in pretty rapidly because Little Max is going to accumulate at least most of those medium tyres. And I really don't want to have to bring Leoncio back in quite as quickly as that. I'm going to give him 8 laps. That way I can leave him out for as long as I need to. He will have to pit again because that's not going to see him all the way through, I don't think. If I push him up onto a higher mode, it's certainly not going to see him all the way through. I'm going to flip him over to softs and start racking up points on that. We'll just see how fast Little Max does that. If I leave him out for the full distance, he should probably be okay. He should be able to fill that gap. Let's hope so in any case. But the other thing too is with Little Max, because he's on qualifying trim, I have to send him out for shorter stints anyway, so I can tweak the amount that I need to have him out for to get that medium value and then bring him in to switch him over to softs. Okay, Leoncio, get the hell out of here. Go, go, go. All right, Little Max. Let's just keep an eye on that level 2 medium tyres and see how fast he's doing that. Let's get up to 2 times. Good part is, the other good part about not doing as many pit stops and doing the pit stops later is, of course, that the setup knowledge bars increase, which means that the mechanics recommended zone decreases, which means that we have a better chance of nailing it. It doesn't massively improve our chances, but it certainly doesn't do us any harm. Okay, so Little Max is up on high at the moment. He's got 2.22 laps left. Let's get back to 1 times because I'm a little concerned. Whereabouts is Little Max? We've got to keep an eye on that. There he is there. Right, 19th. That's Little Max right there. He's down in 19th. I don't care about that because he hasn't been on a high engine mode. He's on medium, so you wouldn't actually expect him to do particularly great. Feels like I've got just the right... Yeah. So you say. 1.48. Right, he can do... Yeah, he can do one more lap. He's going to come in on the next lap anyway. It'll auto because he's going to be low on fuel. Yes, he's there! Damn it! I missed that. Otherwise, I would have brought him in on that lap. All right, Little Max. Push your tires. You can't push your fuel. Otherwise, you'll run out of it. Or can you? Yeah, just... Get up there. I need you back in here as quickly as possible. Come on, Little Max. Get around here. That's 15th. That's Leoncio. All right. Come on, Little Max. Move. Send out. All right. Excellent. Good. Excellent. So I would say always trust your instincts because they got me there with the downforce. But as we know from past experience, my instincts are wrong as often as they're right. In the case of handling, okay, so 75 was... Holy crud. Okay, if 75 was great, that's going to push him outside. All right, so what would take him back towards understeer if we dropped... Oops, sorry, the wrong way. We drop that back to 2.4, that'll keep him just within there. Keeps his speed balance within the excellent zone as well. Or at least I hope it does. Stints will be, of course, 3. There's no point sending him out for just 1. Tire choice will be softs. Get out of here, Little Max. Go. Right, Leoncio, how you doing? You've got 6.83 laps of fuel. All right, race trim is up to level 2. Qualifying trim is... Not quite there yet, but will be very, very soon. So Little Max is back out. Yes, he is. Right, qualifying trim has now jumped up to level 2. How much time? We got 4 minutes 30. This is not looking promising. This is not looking promising for either soft tyres or the trims, actually. Yeah. Leoncio is racking up the race trim pretty nicely. Little Max has the disadvantage that he has to come in more often to the pits anyway, because he can only do shorter stints. Maybe I should have given Leoncio the extra fuel and just left him out for even longer. But the thing is, we don't know for certain that Leoncio... Well, 96% on that first one, the three greats, that's passably adequate. And we still can have another bite at the cherry at trying to get a better setup in the qualifying session. It just occurs to me, I don't know whether you get the bonus. I suppose you would. Really happy with the gear ratios, excellent. Yeah, okay, if you say so. Right, they're both out there on softs now. There's only 2 minutes 42 to go, but with both of them working on it, they'll get up to level 2 without any problem whatsoever. The question is, how well will they do? Let's see what they can do if we push up a little bit. This isn't going to boost their active knowledge gaining, but I just want to see what they can do if I let them go for a lap in a higher mode. We do have to watch the tyre temperatures, though, particularly on Leoncio, because he is well and truly into the red zone. I think we will get level 3 race trim. I don't know about qualifying trim. I certainly don't know about soft tyres. I think I may have wasted a lap there with Little Max. Little Max just got a purple on sector 3. That's really interesting. I'm loving the handling. There's 58 seconds to go. Alright, now apparently, from what I can see, the active knowledge still keeps ticking up if you have already started a lap after the time counts down to 0. So, if Little Max goes past the checkered flag within the next 23 seconds, we've got race trim. We've got qualifying trim. It's going to be close. We're going to do it. Yes. Six packs twice in a row. Now the question is, what was Leoncio's setup like? We shall find out when we get to Quali. Okay, Little Max, 105.846. Okay, 105.846. What's the slowest time? 107.381. Okay, what I wanted to know the slowest time for was qualifying. 107.381. And that's going to let me work out exactly what we're going to do in terms of when we unleash the beast in qualifying. The rest of the times mean absolutely nothing. Scuderia Quantistica, keep up the good work. Shall try to, for your sake, Katarina, and for ours. Wow, I want the race to start now. What are you, a cat? Go Brownlich. Giro. Hey, Giro, I haven't heard from you for a while. Hamilton must be a bit disappointed with how practice went. I was expecting more. I don't care. I'm quite happy about that. Set the pace with Porter leading the way. Love it. Now let's watch us have our backsides handed to us in qualification. Okay, this time we will check the weather first. It's forecast to be dry. Oh, God, it's going to start raining at around about the... What's that? Probably about the 9-minute mark. And that's as far out as we can see. Okay, water on track is going to start building up around 8 minutes. The question is, how much water is going to start building up on the track? Well, we're not going to know that until we start the countdown. Nonetheless, obviously we're going for qualifying trim. 15%, baby! We might as well take those soft tyres anyway, even though it's unlikely that we're going to be able to use them if the rain continues. Depends on what happens at the end. Soft tyres, qualifying trim, confirm that. Car set up, let's see what happened. Oh my God, 3 greens again. Well, that's not actually a coincidence because the settings didn't change. I'll have to re-watch that again, but I'm sure I changed the settings. The intention was to go to 17.7, 27.7. Suspension was supposed to go to 56. And the gear ratios were supposed to go to 63. So that was a wasted opportunity. Well, I mean, we got our active knowledge, but we didn't get an improvement. I mean, 96 I can live with, but I don't like it. 97 is my preferred minimum benchmark. And we got three purple smiley faces on Little Max, which is 99%. That is beautiful. Okay, I just stopped to do some calculations there. Right, the slowest speed in the practice session was 107.3 something something. I don't actually have it written down here because Excel decided to dump the decimal points, but it doesn't really matter because this is just basically bucket mathematics. Let's assume that the outlap and the inlap are about 20 seconds slower. Yes, that's probably exaggerated, but this is a good time to find out because I'd say with that rain, we're going to have zero in the way of track grip, so the timing of doing the send out is going to be less critical because it'll wash away all of the track grip, and therefore it doesn't matter if you time it right to the end. You're just going to be basically doing it on your car's raw grunt, which means that we are screwed. But anyway, let's assume that, okay? So that means that it's going to take about 4 minutes just over to actually do a complete test. Therefore, we need to launch for the last one not much later than 5:59, and we need to launch for the first one not much later than 8:02. We can get away with a little bit of margin on either side. Obviously, the later the better because you know that you're going to be allowed to finish that last lap once the qualification session has ended. Now, that being the case, if we're going to be launching at the 8-minute mark, that is probably going to be intermediate country. Therefore, I am going to do the setup, put it over onto intermediates now, so that we don't waste any time immediately prior to launch. All right, so let's go in there and launch now. Take qualifying. All right, we shall just get the timer down to the 8-minute mark or thereabouts, and then we'll launch. Get it up to four times. 9:34. Has anyone gone out yet? Hamilton's gone out. Why doesn't that surprise me? Okay, now we want it down to about 8 minutes. Go, 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 four times. Has the rain started yet? There is a little bit of moisture on the track. Shut up, Max. Little Max. Actually, Max, tell Little Max to shut up. All right, Baotang, go, go, go. Tire choice is already on inters. Water on track. No, hold. Hold one, about 30 seconds. Cancel. Now go. Continue, continue. Right. Brake heating is likely to be all over the place up here. Every single part of the track is likely to be susceptible to brake heating, so I'm going to put you into auto mode. Little Max is now 7:57. Traffic is relatively clear, or will be by the time you get out. Go, go, go. Tires are cold for Snidely. That's not a surprise. This rain is going to be taking a lot of the heat out. However, Snidely has still managed to overheat both his brakes and his tyres. Nice one, Snide. Where are you? Going to be close. Okay, you've got your tyre temperature perfect. Well done, Snidely. Little Max, your tyre temp's looking good at the moment. Whereabouts are you? You've still got to come up around. Yeah. Okay, tire temp is perfect and locked in. Brakes are overheated. That's okay. How are we looking? Hamilton's already set up a pace. Now, what's the rain doing? It's going to dry up, people. Where the hell's my magnifying glass? All right, so around the 5-minute mark, it's going to dry up. What's the water on track going to do? It's going to evaporate down to zero. Okay, for our second one, which Snidely's on his in-lap. That's actually taking longer than I thought. 5:27, we'll be okay. Come on, Snidely, come on, Snidely. Seventh. Little Max, ninth. Oh, damn it, that was not great. This is above sponsor objective. Four now. 4:53. Okay, so it looks like that 20 seconds was not, in fact, conservative, but rather optimistic. Snidely, get in here. Snidely. You're going to have to go straight back out. 421. Okay, so that's what happened with the handling. Did it? Okay, let me just make a note of that. All right, so obviously we're going to tweak that. It's great that we've got the excellent there. The handling has obviously gone the wrong way, so it was 63 before. Therefore, it's going to have to be 69. That should get us the excellent. Speed balance is knocked out just a little bit, but should still be within the great range, I would think, because nothing shifts that out of great. All right, Snidely, we are going to send you out on a set of softs because the water on track has gone down to damn near nothing. Get out of here, Snidely. Little Max, where the hell are you? And why can't you drive faster? Get in here! You've only got 4 minutes to go! It's going to be interesting to analyse those times and find out exactly how damn slow those outlaps and inlaps are. Go! Right, tyre choice is going to be soft. Move! Don't even get a look at the traffic, we don't have time for that. As it happens, you're okay on that. So is Snidely, by the way. Alright, Snidely's overheated. Come on, Snidely. Come on, Snidely. Come on, Snidely. Get your temperatures down. You can do this, Snide. Yeah! Yes! Perfect! Alright, little Max, how you doing? Bonne chance, my friend! Bonne chance! If you'll pardon me Frenching instead of Italianing. Perfect! Go, little Max! Looks like everybody's out trying it again, starting my flying lap. Alright, Snidely, how you doing? Purple on Sector 1. Oh, well, mind you, he's probably the first one around Sector 1. After the temperatures have dried out, Falco's just taken Purple on Sector 2, previously held by Tang. Alright, Portis green on Sector 1. That's not surprising. Obviously, he's going to be doing better. Falco has set the best time so far. Snidely has set the second best. Little Max is down to 11th, but he's still on his flying lap. Wow, that was nice. Well done, everyone. Alright, second. Above the sponsor objective, and this is the big sponsor objective, because we're getting the 3x bonus. I think it's 3x. In any case, it's a lot of money. Courtesy of our very good friends at Nippon Motor Company. Somebody's just... Oh, that's because Snidely's on his in-lap. That's okay. Actually, he's stuffing people up who are on their... I can send him out, but there's no point. It's 30 seconds. Oh, what the hell. Let's send him out anyway. He'll just be told to come back in, but, you know, just on the off chance, there's no way he's going to get around in 30 seconds. See what he can... Oh, damn it! Yep. We were looking so good there. I was just counting that money, and then it was just taken out of my pocket. 13th and 14th. Like I said... We are basically screwed when it comes to a straight line power shootout with most of the other cars on the grid. Even Falco's ahead of us. Falco doesn't win anything these days. There was no real rubber on the track to allow us a chance there either. That is a damn pity. Stuff you, Margate. Bloody Margate gets another pole. 600,000! And all we had to do was get 10th. 13th, 14th. How far out were we? 105.088. So this, the one in 10th position was Falco at 105.018. So 0.07. That is the difference that is worth 600,000 people. 600,000. Zampelli, Lucatelli are down at the tail end of the field. Bobby Stone for Garuda is behind us as well. I'm presuming they're giving the better car to Falco. And Mikhailovich from Ruiz is behind us too. Damn it! Continue. Career tips for Rebecca Beatty. Retire, admit the Rosato Corsa are the best, and they retire. Here are the Yokohama qualification results. 1, Winston Margate. 2, Zach Hamilton. 3, Estella Batista. Infinity, Quantistica's bank account. Scuderia Quantistica have had a poor qualifying session. You think, Carlotta? It'll be a tough race tomorrow. It's always going to be a tough race until such time as we actually have decent parts. Oh my God, just got tickets for a tour of Scuderia Quantistica HQ. Best birthday ever. Yeah, welcome, Connie. Come around for a drink or something when you get here. We'll have a chat over the suspension. I got to the test track today by bullet train. I wonder if APS cars will ever be able to go that fast. Ours will, once we get a new gearbox, once we get all of the parts replaced. I've just seen 15 Japanese men with tiny Rosato Corsa cars attached to their hats. My life is now complete. Okay, that doesn't surprise me. Went out for a karaoke session with Samuel Blanc last night. Let's say he'd get chucked out of a reality show in the first episode, tone deaf. You've heard me sing, haven't you, Arnold? Because, like, I wouldn't even make the qualification rounds. Okay, there's no mention of us down here. That's not surprising. Let's get over to the race and find that it's probably going to be heavy rain. Okay, there's no rain at all, but there is rain coming. It's going to be coming around about the third lap. Oh, and it's 30 degrees. That's going to be hot and steamy as hell. It's just like the real-life timeline in Sydney here, where we have just started summer and the weather absolutely stinks. It is hot and humid and generally exceedingly unpleasant. We do have bonuses, but the question, if it's going to be at the three-minute mark, we can't really go straight out on inters. We certainly can't go out on wets. What's the water on track going to do? We can't tell. So we're going to be out for about three laps and then have to come in for inters, I suppose. I don't know. We'll have to find out. Join me in about 12 hours and we shall see exactly how we try to untangle this particular mess. In the meantime, if you enjoyed this episode, please do like, subscribe, comment, etc. And I hope to see you in about 12 hours. Until then, have a great weekend and goodbye.